Hello everyone, a hearty welcome to the online lecture series on Readings on Kerala offered by the Postgraduate Department of English, Payyanur College. In this lecture, we'll be discussing the fifth lesson of the text titled Parting from the Path of Life by Chirukadu Govinda Pisharadi. This lesson is an excerpt from his autobiography. First of all, I'll introduce the author to you. And after that, we can have a discussion on the lesson. Chirukadu Govinda Pisharadi is a very prominent Malayalam writer of the 20th century. He is popularly known as Chirukadu, and he also wrote under the pen names like Malangadan and Asad. Chirukadu was born in the year 1914. His parents were Kiriyattil Pisharatha Karunakara Pisharadi and Chirukadu Pisharatha Narayani Pisharasyar. Chirukadu received his early education under local gurus and in local schools. He got elementary training in Sanskrit from Guru Gopal Niruthachan. Chirukadu began his professional career as a school teacher. Later, he joined as faculty of Government College at Pavaratti. He retired as a professor of Malayalam from Government College, Pattambi. Chirukadu was a political activist too. He was associated with the communist movement in Kerala. He was one of the founding members of the Deshabhimani Study Circle and he was one of the predecessors of the Puragamana Kala Sahitya Sangham. His political beliefs and social commitment are well reflected in many of his works. He was a prolific writer who published short stories, novels, poetry collections, plays, etc. Muttashi, Manninte Maril, Bhu Prabhu, Maranapatram, Devalokam, etc. are some of his famous novels. His popular plays are Sneha Bandhangal, Vishuddha Nuna, Chuttu Vilakku and Nammalunna. His famous short story collections are Cheguthaante Koodu and Mudra Modra. He also published poetry collections. His famous poetry collections are Manushyane Manikkuka, Andhapuram, Thiramala, etc. When we analyze his works, we can find that his works are written in the manner of social realism and they are significant for the insight they provide into the life of the downtrodden in pre-independence Malabar. Chirukadu is best known for his autobiography titled Jeevithapada, which was published in the year 1974. It is regarded as a classic in autobiographical narration and it fetched him the Kerala Sahitya Academy Award in the year 1975 and the Kendra Sahitya Academy Award in the year 1976. This autobiography is divided into three sections titled Family, Childhood and Life and it contains 96 chapters. EMS wrote preface to this autobiography. The eminent Malayalam writer M.T. Vasudevan Nair comments that Jeevithapada is equal only to the autobiography of Charlie Chaplin in its simplicity and sincerity. The present lesson titled Parting from the Path of Life is taken from the 8th chapter of the second section of Jeevithapada titled Childhood. It narrates the events of the life of young Chirukadu living under the care of his uncle and his childhood experiences. It is translated by C.B. James. Now let's discuss the lesson in detail. The excerpt begins with a question. Why has this fellow not been taught anything? As we read it, we understand that this question is asked to Kunjamaman. Kunjamaman is the narrator's uncle. The neighbors, the relatives and the guests were all asking the same question to Kunjamaman. And they began asking this question the very day when Cherukada was brought to his mother's house by his father. Now, Cherukada is staying in his mother's house under the care of Kunjamaman. Whenever Kunjamaman is asked this question, he used to get irritated and he preferred to avoid this question. But these people kept on asking the question. Kunjamaman was a busy person. He was constructing a house for his wife during that time. But even then, he tried to teach his nephew something. He tried to teach some astrological calculations and he also wrote for him the quatrains or the shlokas from the Narayaniyam on big palm leaves. As part of this lesson or as part of his teaching, he used to beat his nephew. The narrator's mother couldn't bear this. So she asked Kunjamaman to stop beating her son. Then Kunjamaman stopped teaching his nephew. That is, the basic right to education was denied to Cherukada. Because Kunjamaman couldn't understand how he can teach someone without beating. So he put an end to his teaching. But the people kept on asking the same question. Why don't you teach your nephew anything? Then Kunjamaman would come up with some kind of an excuse or some kind of an illogical answer. He would say that this boy knows a little bit of things. That is, he knows how to read, how to write, and he also knows some astrological calculations. According to Kunjamaman, this is enough. The boy can survive by knowing this much. But the people were not convinced. They couldn't believe it. Because Cherukada was only at the age of 7 at that time. The people couldn't believe that a boy of this age could read, write and do the astrological calculations. This was quite unbelievable for them. So they asked the same question, but this time they put it in a different way. They asked, why don't you send your nephew to the school? It was a time when school education was gaining prominence in Kerala. People were sending their children to the schools. And Kerala was experiencing this educational expansion. Several schools were coming up even in the rural areas. The people from the narrator's own community, that is the Pisharadis, were also sending their children to the school. So that is why these people continued asking the question to Kunjamaman, why don't you send your nephew to the school? Now there comes another character named Paruthiyil Krishnan Nair. Paruthiyil Krishnan Nair is a family friend of Kunjamaman. On one of his visits to their home, Krishnan Nair also asked Kunjamaman, why don't you send your nephew to the school? According to Paruthiyil Krishnan Nair, this family has got everything. This family, Cherato family, is a wealthy family and there is only one boy and this boy is quite efficient and he is very intelligent, and even then, why he is not sent to the school? Krishnan Nair also adds that he has a nephew named Govindan and he is sending Govindan to the school. And this irritated Kunjamaman very much. He was made angry. Then Kunjamaman said, Krishnan Nair can say things like that because he has got a stable income. He has got a salary. But Kunjamaman doesn't have a salary. He also adds that even though there is wealth in this family, there is a wealth of nephews and nieces as well. So what he means to say is that even though There is wealth in this family. There are expenses too. According to him, it is his responsibility to take care of this family members. And he has lot more nephews and nieces. And he has to cater to their needs. And according to him, he can't afford the expenses of sending his nephew to the school. This was his excuse. And some of these relatives, they also put the same question. And they even advised Kunjamaman to send the nephew to the school. According to these relatives, if the boy is sent to the school, he will get a job. And if he gets a job, that would be beneficial for the family. And Cherukadu says that Kunjamaman's condition was like a lawn monkey sitting on a tree who is being pelted with stones from all the sides. That is, on the one side there is Kunjamaman, and on the other side there were all these neighbors, relatives and guests. They were actually verbally attacking Kunjamaman with this question. And Kunjamaman couldn't afford the expense of the narrator's education because it was a time when he was accumulating money from the family income to buy a plot of land for his wife and build a house for his wife and family. And this is significant here because what he was doing was not desirable, because this family was following Marimakkathayam. Marimakkal means nephews and nieces. And this word literally means inheritance by sister's children. Marimakkathayam is a system of matrilineal inheritance which was prominent in Kerala during that time, and this family was following that. As per the system, descent and the inheritance of property was traced through females. Even though the elder male in the family is regarded as the head who could control the entire assets of the family, but the properties were not handed over to him or his children, but to his sisters and their children. That is how this Marimakkathayam worked. And in this context, Kunjamaman is not having any claim over the family property. Instead, the family property would go to the narrator, his mother and his sisters. So that was the dilemma that Kunjamaman was having during that time. Now comes another character named who is actually the son of Vellayamman, and his name is Raghava Pisharadi of Andal. And Raghava Pisharadi also advises Kunjamaman by stressing upon the importance of education. He shares one of his personal experiences with his nephew to Kunjamaman. Raghava Pisharadi's nephew was Raghavan. Raghavan was his sister Nanikutti's son. And according to Raghava Pisharadi, his nephew Raghavan is a prodigal son. He steals things, he tells lies, and he even has illicit sexual relationships, etc. And he tried all the possible means to advise him, to show him the right path. But this Raghavan, this nephew, didn't listen to any of his words, and he always did what he liked. Having fed up with his nephew, Raghava Pisharadi threw him out of the house. Then Raghavan used to roam around the temple and he started stealing the Kanam rice which belonged to this family, that is Raghava Pisharadi's family. And these people are left to starve. One day, Raghava Pisharadi hid in the temple kitchen. And his nephew, Raghavan, came and he tried to steal the rice from the chembu, the large vessel. Then immediately Raghavapisharadi came out and he shouted at Raghavan, "This Kanam rice belongs to us. How dare you touch this? Don't you know that there are several members in the family who are depending upon this Kanam rice? Then how dare you touch this Kanam rice?" Then Raghavan asked his uncle, "Don't I have to eat them?" Then what happens? There is a tug of war between this uncle and nephew. Both of them were trying to pull this chembu to their side. In between, this nephew Raghavan bites Raghavapisharadi and he steals the chembu and he runs away. Raghavapisharadi finds that blood was dripping from his hand. If the blood is spilled inside the temple, it would desecrate or pollute the temple. So he pressed his wound and stepped out of the temple. This was his experience. And he narrates this experience to Kunjamaman. Kunjamaman was actually shocked to listen to this experience of Raghavapisharadi. And he realizes that there are two chief enemies to a matrilineal family head. Enemy number one is the efficient husband of a woman in a family. The efficient husband of a woman in the family. And number two is a grown-up nephew who bites back, which means a grown-up nephew who can be a rebel. In Kunjamaman's case, he will not be having any threat from the first enemy. Who is the first enemy? The first enemy for Kunjamaman is the narrator's father. But the narrator's father is a very soft and nice person. He is a very gentle person. And he will not make any troubles. And he is a harmless person. And the other main members in the family are the husbands of the narrator's sisters. The narrator has got two sisters, Kutti Oppol and Malu Oppol. Kutti Oppol's husband was leaving the house because he didn't want to confront with this Kunjamaman. He didn't want to quarrel with Kunjamaman and he was willingly leaving the house in order to avoid the quarrel. And there is no threat from him for Kunjamaman. And the next one is Malu Oppol's husband. He is known as Black Patteri. And according to Charugadu, this Black Patteri is a fool and he is also a harmless person. Which means Kunjamaman doesn't have any threats from the first enemy. And there is only one threat to him. There is only one enemy to him. Who is that? That is Charugadu himself, his nephew. And Kunjamaman senses the danger that if Charugadu grows up, he can question the authority of Kunjamaman. He realizes that. This is where this excerpt ends. So here we can find that Charugadu is narrating even his painful experiences with a tinge of humor in it. Here, we can also find the social history of Kerala when it is touching upon the practice called Marumakkathayam and also when it is referring to the spread of school education, etc. This excerpt also throws light upon the subjugation experienced by the children in a patriarchal society because of certain restrictions and impositions which are laid upon them. So hope you could understand this lesson, and we shall wind up the discussion of this lesson. Next we'll be moving on to the comprehension questions.
Question number one. What was the question that everyone frequently asked Kunjamaman? Answer. Everyone frequently asked Kunjamaman why his nephew was not taught anything. Question number 2. What did Kunjamaman do to escape from this question? Answer. Kunjamaman found time to teach Cherugad astrological calculations. He wrote quatrains from the Narayaniyam on big palm leaves for Cherugad. Thus, Kunjamaman tried to escape from the question. Question number 3. Why did Kunjamaman stop teaching the narrator? Answer. As part of the lesson, Kunjamaman used to beat the narrator. When the narrator's mother asked Kunjamaman to stop beating her son, he stopped teaching the narrator. Question number 4. What explanation does Kunjamaman give to Paruthil Krishnanayar for not sending the narrator to school? Answer. Kunjamaman said that Krishnanayar had a salary, but he hadn't. He also said that even though there was wealth in his family, he had a wealth of nephews and nieces as well. It means there are other expenses in the family. Hence, he can't bear the expensive education of his nephew. Question number 5. What, according to the relatives, was the advantage of sending the narrator to school? Answer. According to the relatives, if the narrator is sent to the school, he would get a job and that would be beneficial for the family. Question number 6. What made Kunjamaman ignore some of the queries regarding the narrator's education? Answer. Kunjamaman was squirreling away money from the family income to buy a house and a piece of land for his wife. So, he was unable to afford the expenses of the narrator's education. Hence, he preferred to ignore the queries regarding the narrator's education. Question number 7. Why did Raghava Pisharadi throw his nephew Raghavan out of his house? Answer. Raghava Pisharadi's nephew Raghavan used to tell lies, steal things and commit adultery. He didn't pay any attention to his uncle's advice and did what he liked. So, Raghava Pisharadi threw him out of his house. Question number 8. How did the nephew Raghavan manage to make a living after being thrown out of the house by his uncle? Answer. After being thrown out of the house, Raghavan managed to make a living by stealing their kanam rice from the temple. He stole the rice, ate some, sold the rest, and bought bidis and smoked away his earnings. Question number 9. What was the inheritance system followed by the narrator's family? Based on this, who was considered as the head of their family? Answer. The narrator's family followed the matrilineal inheritance system. Based on this system, the elder male known as Karanava is the head of the family. Question number 10. Who, according to the narrator, were the chief enemies of a matrilineal family head? Answer. According to the narrator, a matrilineal family head's chief enemies were the efficient husband of a woman in the family and a grown-up nephew who bites back. That is, a nephew who could become a rebel.
Thank you.